Hey everybody, this is Brian. Welcome to the 9th C# tutorial. Let's go ahead and create a console application. Today we're going to be covering arrays. What are arrays? Well, let's say you want to make a bunch of variables. Like you want a line in a bank, and you want to have, you know, person 1, Bob, person 2, we'll just make up a name here, Mary, and person 3, and we'll just say the dude. We don't know who he is. Now you can make a couple variables and call them one at a time, but it's much easier if you make what's called an array. And to do that, we're just going to say string and then brackets. Let's actually scroll down here so you can see what's going on. And we'll just call this people equal new string. And then let's just give it a count of 3. So now we have what's called an array. Now, it has a normal variable, but notice these brackets. What we're saying is there's more than one of them in there. And to kind of prove this, what we're going to do is say people, and then we want 0, and we're just going to say Bob, and then people 1, we're going to say Mary, people 2, we're going to say the dude, because we don't know who he is. So this would just be a basic representation of people in line at a bank. Now, why would you use an array? A lot of people ask, hey, if you can already make a string, why don't you just make a bunch of strings? Why even bother with an array? Well, simple. So you can do something like this. For each, and we'll say string customers in people. So you want to know the names of all the people in line at the bank. Let's kind of scroll down here. So we're just going to say console write line customers. Actually, let's call that customer, because we're only grabbing one. Oops. Sorry about that. And then console read. That way we keep our console window open here. So this is a very simple representation of how you'd make an array. Now you notice how we've got an array of strings. So we're saying we have more than one string in this variable called people. And it's a new string, and then we give it a number. We're giving it an upper limit. And notice we're saying 3. 1, 2, 3. Once again, don't get thrown off by that 0. Computers always start with 0 as the first number. So that is first, second, and third. And then we're going to use our for each loop. We're going to say for each customer in people. We're just going to print them out here. So let's run this. Sure enough, Bob, Mary, the dude. So that, in its simplest terms, is an array. This is Brian. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this educational and entertaining.